What's up? I'm Mark. In this video, I'm walking you through how to post your video clips from your podcast onto your LinkedIn and how to get the most mileage out of it. Take a look below in the description. There's going to be some step-by-step instructions because sometimes the algorithms shift slightly on these social media platforms. So just make sure you read below to make sure you stay up to date. So step one, you're going to open up your Google folder where all of your images and videos and clips are. And we're going to find the episode that we're looking to promote, that person that we're looking to collaborate with online. And that's really the way I see these posts looking. They're a collaboration. You're collaborating. You're a small business partner with someone for a short period of time. So it's really important that we maximize this opportunity. So today we're going to be promoting a clip from Jeff McKinnon. So I'm going to go ahead and click here. And for this client, I'm going to have some vertical shorts. And this is the video that I'm going to be posting. How to overcome doubters when starting a business. Let's go ahead and download this. You can see it's just going to start downloading. You can also do this right from your smartphone. Super simple. Go ahead and download it. Boom. We've got our video there. All right. So now that we're over here on LinkedIn, we're simply going to click on our little video icon and we're going to select the video, which is, you know, the top of the list here. This is a vertical style video. In this particular clip, you know, we are going to change them up, optimize them based on your platform of choice. But let's talk about the type, the text here, because I think this is really important. And there's a few things I want to accomplish here in this text. We're always going to start with a hook, something that makes someone say, okay, I've been triggered. That can be through a quote or something controversial that you might say. It's just that your hook is important. It should be very brief, only a few words. Then we're going to get into the meat and potatoes where we're going to shout out the people that are relevant. And then we're going to have a call to action at the end, followed by some hashtags. So let me walk you through this real quick. I'm going to fast forward it, and then I'm going to write the copy so you can see what we've got here. So let's go ahead and break down. All right, cool. So we've written out all of our copy here. It's taken me less than 5 minutes, and I'm just going to walk you through a little bit of what I'm thinking here. So, A, we know that the theme of this video is how to overcome doubters when starting a business. So we know it's going to be about overcoming doubt. We know it's about that grind of entrepreneurship and getting past it. This little snippet of information here is really important. To me, that dictates and guides how the whole clip and all our copywriting should go. Doesn't hurt to actually watch the video as well. So you make sure that your copy is aligned. Again, the copy is a way to tweak someone to get in there. So again, the hook, this is what you need to do, period. Does that sound familiar? Everyone has an opinion of the actions that you should take. And when you're starting a business, there will be plenty of questions. And you know, one of the things that I like doing with copy is always looking for ways to write, to say more with less words. Too many words is a problem. That's another reason why I like to spread this out so it becomes easier for people to digest, right? You're not just reading or sending over a big wall of text. It's itemized, boom, boom, boom. I find it reads, it's easier for people to read through it, right? Then we get in, obviously we're gonna tag our guest here. That is really, really important. And it's easily done by just hitting our at sign, Jeff McKinnon, right? And we see his name there and we just click on him there. Nothing wrong with tagging multiple parties, multiple interests. I only tag typically people that the post is very relevant to. Some people on LinkedIn might tag 24 people in their post. A little bit spammy, not a huge fan of that personally. But I always make sure that I tag interested parties. So in this case, it's Jeff McKinnon. Maybe I tag his business. Maybe there's a business partner that was referenced in the clip. The more relevant people that are tagged in here, the better. And I think that, at least for me, when I think about tagging, I tag someone because I want to show them recognition, right? It's kind of like when you're standing up to say, I just want to thank all the employees who made this happen. I want to thank my mom for making it. You're giving a shout out. You're giving thanks to all the people that contributed to the making of this clip. And I think what some people get wrong when it comes to tagging is they just tag everybody in their network so that people will comment and post so that it gets more reach. Personally, I like to tag people to give them recognition, not to spam them. So that is my perception here. Tag the people that you give recognition to. that you want to give recognition to. And then we have a little bit of, you know, like a little bit of our message, just like you should believe in you, stop doubting, start the action. And then listen to the episode today. I'm just going to listen. Or I might even just break this down. Listen today. Boom. And there's a link. Now, it's really important that you share the link to your episode in this post. Because anybody that shares this post, you want to make sure that link is in the post. Sometimes people will put links in the comments, and that's fine. I really recommend that you put your link in the post itself. That way, when the guest shares this out, when people share this out, the link to your podcast episode will be right there. There's different schools of thought. You and me will definitely have a strategy of the best link to be sharing. For me right now, it's straight to my Buzzsprout episode. But again, for you, we might be sharing a different link. Again, that's why you work with me. We're going to develop a specialized plan that works for you, for your guest, and for your audience. And then lastly down here, you'll see I like to use 5 relevant hashtags here: entrepreneur, entrepreneurship, After Hours Entrepreneur, the name of this podcast, hashtag Jeff McKinnon, hashtag websites, which is the business that he's in. You know, you can play with different things. I generally try to stick to around 5 relevant hashtags. And that is it, my friends. We're going to go ahead and post this up. You can see it's posting. And then when this goes live, it's going to notify automatically anybody that we've tagged, and they'll have the opportunity to reshare. And that, my friends, is how you post a video to LinkedIn. Go ahead, start posting, start tagging, and watch the magic happen. Thanks for being the best part of Mark Savant Media. Now go take action. Peace.